Skywatch Media News for February the 6th, 2020. There are reports recently circulating across various news sites and tabloid magazines claiming that the Earth is about to enter into a 30-year mini ice age, where temperatures are expected to dip to minus 50 degrees centigrade in the coldest regions of the world. This is what scientists are now warning us to prepare for, as an ominous solar minimum grips the planet. NASA has indicated that the sun will reach its lowest point of activity in the last 200 years. This is expected to occur sometime this year. The sun entering into a natural state of hibernation could actually threaten to trigger food shortages as the temperatures begin to plummet. What is expected to occur is a drop of as much as 1 degree in global temperatures, lasting for an indefinite period of time. This according to Valentina Zarkova, who you may know is a well-known astrophysicist. Her models on climate and the solar magnetic field hypothesis have been run with an incredible 97% accuracy, and she is now predicting that there is a super grand solar minimum coming our way. Now, when we think of a 1 degree differential in global temperatures, that may not seem like much, but in reality, it is very significant with respect to global average temperatures. It really does make a big difference when it comes to climatic conditions. The sun is approaching the point of hibernation. Less sunspots are forming on the solar surface, and therefore less energy and solar radiation is being emitted towards the Earth's atmosphere, as well as the more distant planets of our solar system. Solar minimums normally take place in their natural cycle, but this one is especially interesting because it could mark the start of a rare event here on Earth, known as the Grand Solar Minimum, where sunspot activity is almost non-existent, and energy from the sun drops significantly across the solar system. Events such as the one now being forecast only happen every 400 years or so, and that is why they are considered so rare. Evidence of an unusual solar minimum are already being felt in such places as Canada and Iceland, where the influx in cosmic rays over the past several years is resulting in a dimmer atmosphere. Therefore, the reduction in temperatures results in extremely cold and wet periods in the winter, along with both wet and cold summers. But this is just the start of what is anticipated to occur on planet Earth in the years ahead. The last grand solar minimum to be felt on Earth was the Maunder minimum back in the mid-17th century. It lasted for 70 years. During this time, the sun's brightness dimmed considerably, and temperatures plummeted across the globe. Today's scientific readings of solar activity suggest the Earth could find itself in a similar situation. Right now, the hope is that another mini ice age, if it does occur in the coming years, will not be as substantial as was the Maunder minimum. But solar activity in today's generation is becoming increasingly unpredictable. If the effects are substantial, then what we can expect to see is a drastic reduction in food harvest across middle latitudes. Fruits, vegetables, and grains for livestock will not be able to survive long enough for the harvest to occur. This could lead to severe food depletion for both humans and animals. We are already seeing the effects of this cycle in countries such as Spain and Greece, where snow was falling in April and May, resulting in the devastation of vegetable crops. Meanwhile, in the UK, there was a deficit of both veggies and fruits. It's difficult to say what effect a grand solar minimum has on the Earth's climate. The plummeting temperatures during the Maunder minimum could have been triggered by several different factors, including the distribution of volcanic ash across the planet as the result of a series of tremendous eruptions during that time period. So it's entirely possible that a grand solar minimum may have little effect on global temperatures. We just don't know for sure. Some of you have questioned whether low sunspot activity and the lack of solar rays is a triggering mechanism for big earthquakes and for volcanic eruptions on the planet. If these charts are any indication, then there most likely is some sort of correlation between what happens on the surface of the sun and what takes place here on Earth. If you look at the 10 largest earthquakes from the years 1906 through the year 2011, and compare their seismicity with the number of sunspots in those particular years, you will see that the larger earthquakes generally occur at low sunspot numbers, as shown on the black columns. Now that sunspot activity is once again at all-time lows, we are seeing a similar situation occurring with seismic and volcanic earth changes across the globe. The threats imposed upon us from the wavering activity of the sun is not the only threat that our planet faces. There is the ever-increasing dangers posed by near-Earth objects, including large meteors and asteroids that are coming our way from the depths of our solar system. These Caltech Observatory numbers are an indicator of the steadily increasing discovery of NEOs. Since the year 2012, the numbers of dangerous asteroids has skyrocketed, and there is no reason to believe that 2020 will see a decline in these numbers. On Monday night, February the 3rd, just prior to midnight British time, a meteor fireball exploded over the northern countryside, lighting up the night sky. The sighting was recorded by the UK Meteor Observation Network website. This was not the only sighting originating from the British Isles. On that evening, there was a flurry of meteor sightings across the UK and the Netherlands. Just recently, a major explosion took place above California when a space rock crashed into the Earth's atmosphere at nearly 56,000 kilometers per hour, which is a staggering 34,675 miles per hour. The bright blast lit up the night sky, prompting hundreds of calls to the International Meteor Organization. The explosion was initially reported as space debris from a satellite re-entering the atmosphere, but further research determined that it was actually an incoming meteoroid, traveling at an incredible speed, producing a steady stream of small blasts as it entered the atmosphere. On the same evening of the California blast, a breathtaking fireball event took place over the Ural region of Russia. The stunning spectacle was captured blazing across the sky over the town of Irbit. The burst of light was so intense that it was actually observed 500 miles from its point of origin. We see the Earth slowly transforming into a wilderness, warning us of the dangers before us. We feel the suffering of millions of people. And yet, as we look towards the sky, we begin to feel that the changes will be for the better, that the cruelty of this world will end, so that peace and tranquility will return one day. Thanks for watching.